And part two of this mini series on how to improve your sleep, I'll be sharing a number of tips on how you can improve your REM sleep so that it can go from this to this. First, if you're new to HRV Hackers, we use research-based advice to improve our health and heart rate variability. I would love to have you join me as a subscriber if you haven't yet. Okay, so what role specifically does REM play during our sleep stages? REM is the fourth sleep stage. Since REM sleep starts to ramp up throughout the night, and the longer that you stay asleep, the more likely you will have a chance to get more REM sleep. One of the strategies in this video is going to be how to keep you asleep longer. Some of the benefits to improving your REM sleep could be seen in improved mental health and improved learning abilities. Now, before we jump into the REM-tastical strategies that are going to improve your REM sleep, I want to briefly mention the video that I did prior to this that talked about strategies for deep sleep. Now, the reason why I would suggest you check out that video after this one is because a number of supplements and ideas in there that have been scientifically validated to improve deep sleep have also been scientifically validated to improve REM sleep. So that's a total win-win. Now, if you're busy, if you don't have a chance to do so, don't worry, I'll still briefly cover some of these wonder supplements in this video as well. I think this video is to be used as medical advice. Always consult with your doctor, especially if you have a medical condition. Okay, so the first idea that I want to get on your radar is niacinamide. So niacinamide, aka vitamin B3, aka niacin without the niacin flush where your face turns red. Niacinamide is known to cross the blood-brain barrier and has been compared to Valium, which is a highly addictive benzo, but you'll be getting it in a safe, non-addictive form. Niacinamide has been shown to increase how much 5-HTP is converted to serotonin. And in a small study, niacinamide has been shown to greatly increase REM sleep. Next, let's talk about a wonder supplement that I've talked about in the deep sleep video called glycine. A recent study showed that supplementation with glycine caused a drop in body temperature, which is a very good thing when we're sleeping. And at the same time, it helped people fall asleep more quickly and spend more time in REM sleep. Would highly, highly advise you to check out glycine today. I personally take 3 grams a night. Next, I'd like to bring your attention to another wonder supplement called magnolia. Now, magnolia has been shown to benefit anxiety, depression, and improving both REM sleep and deep sleep. And as a bonus for the menopausal women watching this video, it has been also shown to improve symptoms of that as well. Part of the reason why magnolia works so well for these symptoms to calm down our nervous system and give us better sleep is because it increases the amount of neurotransmitter called GABA in our system. And the version that I use is called Relora. And the reason why I use it is because it's a combination of Magnolia officinalis and Phalloendron amurensi bark extracts. So if you're gonna go for magnolia anyway, might as well give yourself the most bang for the buck and try out this combination. Now, question for you. What happens when you take a relatively good supplement such as L-theanine and another relatively good supplement such as GABA and combine them together? Well, according to a mouse study that was done relatively recently, you would have an increase in both your REM sleep and your deep sleep. So that sounds like an excellent, excellent combination. And while we're at it, I want to briefly point your attention to a supplement that I used to take that seems to literally have every single ingredient that you need to improve your REM sleep. Check this out. So going down the list, it has magnesium, it has GABA, it has taurine, it has L-theanine, it has Relora. This is definitely a great supplement. Now, by the way, I have no affiliation with this company, but I just thought I'd share it with you because, like, hey, why buy 5 different supplements when you can just get it all together in one? Now, an important thing you can do to both improve your sleep and your health is actually to get both your calcium and magnesium levels tested. Because if you're deficient in either of these, your REM sleep is going to suffer because you're not going to be able to stay asleep long enough in order to get enough REM sleep. Now, these tests are so basic that even your regular doctor should be willing to prescribe this lab test for you to make sure that you're not deficient. So your brain uses calcium to convert tryptophan into melatonin. Also, people with low calcium levels often wake up only a couple of hours after falling asleep and have a hard time going back to sleep. Magnesium improves your sleep efficiency and lengthens your sleep time, which is particularly important for REM sleep. Now, quick note, most of you that have been watching my channel know that I'm a huge fan of magnesium supplementation, such as... But what you might not know is that I'm not a fan of calcium supplementation at all. I think whenever possible, you should try to get your calcium through food because there's a risk of both colon polyps and kidney stones from calcium supplementation. Light exposure. Now, while a lot of the people watching this video on my channel already know about the wonders of blue light blocking glasses, not everyone I know is also aware that a couple of hours before you go to sleep, you also really, really, really want to be cautious of light intensity, which means whenever possible, dim the lights in your room and any light that you're going to be exposed to the absolute lowest levels possible. Because a study that compared subjects that read an e-reader versus a book before sleep, the subjects that read an e-reader had a much shorter REM sleep phase. And the theory is that it wasn't just because of the blue lights that your glasses are blocking for you, but it was also because of the intensity of the lights from the e-reader. And finally, I want to mention a couple of supplements that even though there is no direct scientific evidence that they help REM sleep, there is a lot of anecdotal evidence out on the internets of people having success, and they are lion's mane and choline supplements. Now, personally, I haven't experienced anything from either of them, but my physiology is different than your physiology, and you might have better luck. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed the REM portion of this Improve Your Sleep series. Leave me a comment with what's been helping with your REM sleep, and I will see you in the next video.